this is Chinmay. Today I'm going to be introducing you to our Shih Tzu family. So let me take you right in. So we first had our Shih Tzu. This one was actually adopted by somebody else. Our first Shih Tzu, our first puppy, was adopted by somebody else, and then I believe they no longer wanted it, and that's how our first boy of the family happened. We call him a million different names. My mother named him Patappa, we called him Upliyappan, and I call him Paplush and everything else that comes to my mood at that point in time. So he is the first son of this family. Thereafter, my mother got a girl Shih Tzu, which she named Jillu actually. So this is Jillu and Paplush, and they both had a litter of puppies a few months ago. The thing is, Jillu was not lactating enough, and in spite of the fact that we had four puppies, we had two boys and two girls. The only one that survived was the girl, which is with us right now. We did want to actually give it up in adoption, and that then at some point in time, my mother felt that she was not willing to, you know, let go. So also, this is the first grandchild of this family, and I'm a grandmother. Yay! So we have, I think we are also calling her like a million different names: Potato, Bubbly, Neelu, everything that we feel like, right? So we also call her Rangasani. It's from a song in Telugu. So all that we keep calling her, and it's been a joy having pets at home. Especially, I think once you adopt a dog, it completely changes your life. It makes everything, you look at animals itself very, very differently. I think it's changed me and Rahul as a person. It's changed us as people, and it makes us, they are part of our family. Whenever we travel, I have shared that video as well as to how we travel with pets on Air India. Air India ki jai ho, because if not for Air India, I don't think we would have been able to manage our residences in Hyderabad and Chennai, and then taking our puppies there. So this is generally just going to be showing you some video of them prancing about and all that. One of the best things that I have seen, I saw Jillu giving birth. I took care of that. At that point in time, I was also going through typhoid. So it was actually pretty hectic. But I learned a lot. I learned about keeping puppies warm, especially as soon as they are born, and how to manage if the mother puppy is not lactating enough. I learned everything in that. And unfortunately, no matter how much we tried, we were not able to save three puppies. Rahul had actually named one of the boys Sudarshan and all that. So so it would have been nice. I think he called it Sudarshan Venkatesh. The girl was called something else, I forgot. I think the first girl was the first baby that we lost that day. And then it was very difficult losing the puppies, seeing them, you know, literally pass away in the palm of your hand. And it was extremely difficult. And at this point in time, I need to also give a shout out to Shravan. Shravan is somebody that I think you must follow on Instagram. This guy, you may have seen him as a child artist in Anjali, and he runs Besant Animal Dispensary. I think that's what it's called. He's a rescuer. He rescues a lot of snakes around the city. He's somebody that I really admire. He rescues a lot of abandoned dogs, especially all these dogs like Great Danes and, you know, all these luxury, you know, people who think that it's very cool to have a, you know, great looking dog. Oh, I have a Great Dane. Oh, I have a Shih Tzu. Oh, I have this, I have that. And then they bite, and then they don't see that these need to be taken care of as well. And at some point in time, they get bored, and then they just dump these dogs in the middle of the road. So Shravan has rescued countless dogs, horses, cats. He picks up dogs from the road and he helps in rehabilitating, helps them recuperate, and helps them get adopted into really good homes. A recent story that I saw was him sharing about this Great Dane, which a girl actually, who was dumped, I think once they were done with her, perhaps she was being bred too much. And then finally they rehabilitated the Great Dane, and then the Great Dane was given up for adoption. I don't understand why people do this. I don't understand why people just buy dogs from breeders who also indulge in a lot of unhealthy breeding practices and unhygienic living conditions for these dogs, and they just have a cute puppy which is Instagram worthy, which is kind of sad. Anyway, you should follow Shravan on Instagram. You should see the kind of work that he does.
I think you may remember the story of Bhadra, the dog which was thrown off from the terrace of a building by two medical students. I don't know what happened of them or if they are different human beings right now, but the entire city and whoever knew about the story of Bhadra were looking at who the students were. So Shravan and his two friends, they were the ones who, I'm not able to remember, I think the other lady was Jenny, if I remember right. If I've gotten the names wrong, I'm going to correct that and enter it in the description box down below. So they had gone, located who the medical students were, and rehabilitated Bhadra. And there was of course a lot of demand because Bhadra had become the superstar dog, and everybody was like, I'll take care of Bhadra, I'll take care of Bhadra, I'll take care of Bhadra. So finally they found Bhadra a very, very nice, lovely home as well. So Shravan is somebody who's been continuing to work on animal welfare, rescue and rehabilitation, no matter what the animal or the reptile. So coming back, he had told me, I mean, I had called Shravan and I had asked help on how to take care of them as well, how to help, you know, get them to survive and stuff like that. And I had also asked him once for advice on how to rehabilitate a squirrel's baby. I don't know how exactly you call the little ones of squirrels. So I had it had fallen off the nest, and I was trying to figure out how to, you know, rehabilitate that. And it was very, very similar on how you would take care of a newborn puppy who is probably not feeding well from its mother. Anyway, so I'm going to leave you right about now, and just going to give you some very happy visuals of our very lovely Shih Tzu family. I know I have a pedigree, pure breed sort of a dog. I know my breed is exotic, but I would really urge you that if you're looking at getting home a dog, please look at adopting. Please look at seeing. If you're looking at a pedigree dog, please see if anybody in your friend circle has or are having puppies instead of actually buying it from breeders. Or if you're looking at breeders, please make sure that they are really good ones. There is no inbreeding. Go visit the pedigree, I mean the breeder's facility, to see how well they are taken care of. Even otherwise, even if Shravan is watching this video, he'll probably kill me for even saying this, but there is no point in even, I realize that a lot of people are not going to stop buying pedigree dogs. I know that they are not going to stop importing, or of course I think there has been a recent ban on importing purebreds from other countries because of so many issues. Anyway, please understand that if you're bringing in a dog, it requires to be taken care of. It, you need to take care of it just as you would a human baby. And it's something that will give you unconditional love. It is a member of your family. It is not something that you're going to be keeping away, keeping it chained outside your house or the gate, or keeping it outside with very minimal human contact. If you're going to get a dog and just going to have the staff in your house take care of it, don't bother. Please don't bother. Please make sure that you're giving a dog a good home. That's very, very important. That's about it. I really, really hope if you decide to ever adopt a dog, I really hope that you're able to provide a lovely home for the dog or the cat or any other, animal that you would decide to adopt at some point in time. Anyway, take good care of yourselves, and if you have such furry members from the animal family in your family and home as well, please take good care of them as well. Until I see you in the next video, this is Chinmay Singh.